What's up, game developers? CouchFerret here, and today we'll continue our archery game with shooting animation in Unity. We create an archer who can move and aim in different directions at the same time. Because this topic is a bit bigger, I've broken it down into two parts, so come back next time for part two. If it sounds fun, then stay with me and consider subscribing so you won't miss any future videos of this game. Cool, let's begin! Our plan is to make our character move in one direction while aiming in a different direction. This is harder than it sounds. The problem is that if we make each aiming direction together, with 6 running animations, 6 walking animations, and 1 idle animation, then every single aiming direction will have 13 animations, so all 8 aiming directions will end up with a total of 104 animations. Surely, there must be an easier way. After a bit of searching and thinking, I ended up with a possible solution. We need to cut the archer in half and control the legs separately from the body. If we control it with a separate animator controller, then we don't need all the combinations of the legs and body. This way, we will have 6 running, 6 walking, and 1 idle animation for the legs, and 6 running, 6 walking, 1 idle, and 8 aiming animations for the body. This should be much easier to handle. Let's export out last episode's sprite sheet again, but this time we have to separate the body from the legs. We need to make visible only the bottom and the bottom shadow layers and hide the rest. Let's export the sprite sheet as bottom part. Next, let's export the body while the legs are hidden. Because we saved the PNGs directly to our project's directories, they are already imported, but we need to set a few parameters to make them usable. Let's change filter mode to point no filter and compression to none, and hit apply. Then we need to scroll up and change sprite mode to multiple and open up the sprite editor. Let's slice it by grid by cell size of 30 by 30 pixels and do the same to top part as well. Now we have all the necessary slices. To have a clearer structure, let's create a hole and a split folder and move the previous Archer graphics to the hole directory and the new ones to the split. Let's do the same with the animations. Now, let's create the bottom part's animations. We need to select the first 6 slices and drag it into the scene to create a new game object. Save the animation as bottom run left. Next, remove the underscore 0 from our game object's name. And also do the same to the new animator controller that Unity created for our bottom animations. Okay, we need to go to the animator window and also open the animation window as well, so we can create all the bottom animations we need. Let's navigate to the graphics folder where the slices are and create a new clip in the animation window. Name it bottom run right and drag the slices from 6 to 11 into the timeline. Change the sample rate to 12 and repeat the process for all the running and walking animations. Okay, I've jumped ahead a bit in time, and now we have all the necessary animations. Let's create a new Archer game object and drag the bottom part game object into it. We need to set the bottom part's coordinates to zeros. Let's duplicate our existing player controller script so we can start modifying it to work with the two parts of our character. You can duplicate it with Ctrl D or Command D, depending on your operating system. Let's open up the new script and rename the class so it won't throw errors. We have to change the animator variable to have one for the top and one for the bottom. And also, we have to fix the existing references to the animator variable by changing it to bottom animator. Using the selector, we can assign bottom part's animator component to the variable. Let's copy the crosshair from the previous archer, rename it, and fill the crosshair variable with it so it won't cause errors when we test the game. And also, don't forget to drag the arrow prefab into the last variable. Let's test it to make sure everything works as previously. The movement, aiming, and shooting works, so we can focus on the bottom part's animator. But before that, let's disable the old archer so we won't control two archers at the same time, and also we've forgotten to reset the new crosshair's position. Okay, it's time to work on the bottom part's animator controller. Let's create the same animation parameters we had in our previous controller. All of them are float parameters. To save some time, let's copy the whole blend tree state from the previous controller. Let's double-click it to access the blend tree, because we need to change the animations. This blend tree is a 2D freeform directional one with all the run and walk animations in perfect hexagons. If you want to know how it works and how to create one, then click the card in the top right corner of this video to see a previous episode which explains all of it. Let's replace all the motion fields animations with the bottom one. Now we can go back to the base layer to make the transitions. First, let's remove all the simple animation states. Oops, we forgotten to create an idle animation. Let's create one fast by using the third slice in the bottom part sprite sheet. We need to set the bottom idle state as layer default and also rename it simply to just idle. Let's have a transition from idle to run and uncheck has exit time and fix duration. Then let's set transition duration to 0. We have to create a condition with magnitude greater than 0 to transition to the run state when we move the joystick. To stop running at some point, we need to create a transition from run to idle, uncheck has exit time and fix duration, and set transition duration to 0. The condition should be magnitude less than 0.001. And we are done with the bottom part. Let's test it. It works. Cool. That's it for today, folks. In part 2, we will finish the top part to have aiming and shooting animations. We will be able to aim and run in different directions at the same time and play the arrow releasing animation when we fire. So be sure to subscribe and leave a thumbs up. If you have any questions about what you have just seen, feel free to ask and I try to answer all of them. See you next time!